Hello, it's Maria here, your narrator for a crazy story I am about to tell. We caught wind that the Cat in the Hat can only bring one individual with him on one of his crazy adventures to the Candyland. He is struggling to decide between bringing Thing One or Thing Two. He has decided to take a closer look at their chromosomes and determine which one will be more fit for his adventure. We can see that within Thing One's two chromosomes, there is something different. There seems to be some sort of an inversion. If we take a closer look into each chromosome, we can see where they are similar. If we rearrange one of the chromosomes to where the loci match up between both, we can see that the loci K, J, and I are different. The inversion is pericentric because the inverted area I, J, and K includes the centromere. Now we will draw the chromosomes out the same way they would synapse in meiosis, and since there is an inversion, the chromosomes will be drawn out with the loop to make up for the inversion. After we draw out each chromosome with both chromatids, we have to make sure the homologous regions line up in and outside of the loop. If a crossover occurs between the J and the K loci, it will look like this. Now, in order to determine which chromatids produce viable gametes, we have to check and see if we have everything we need. If we start off with the top chromatid I have highlighted in red, we will pick up MLI centromere JKHG. Then, if we move to the bottom chromatid of chromosome 1, I will pick up MLI centromere JKLM that I have highlighted in blue. Then, if we move to chromosome 2 and look at the first chromatid I have highlighted in red, we will pick up MLKJ centromere IHG. Then, if we move to the bottom chromatid I have highlighted in green, we will pick up GHKJ centromere IHG. From this, we can see that gamete 1 would be viable, gamete 2 would not be viable, gamete 3 would be viable, and gamete 4 would not be viable. Now, if we take a look at Thing 2's chromosomes and we rearrange its loci, we see that it's normal. If we draw out the chromosomes, both with each chromatid, and line it up, with the crossover between J and K, then it will look like this. If we look at chromosome 1 and look at the first chromatid I have highlighted in red, we will pick up MLI centromere JKHG. Then, if we look at the second chromatid on chromosome 1 that I've highlighted in blue, we will get the same outcome. Then, if you look at chromosome 2, we will get the same thing for both chromatids, even though there is a crossover between J and K. As you can see, all four gametes are viable because they are all the same. We have everything we need, loci G through M, and none of the gametes have been duplicated or deleted. Since Thing 1 has less viable gametes than Thing 2, he is seen as less fit than Thing 2, who produced all viable offspring. The Cat in the Hat caught wind of these differences and decided to only take Thing 2 on his wild adventure to the world filled with candy. This is everything Thing 2 has ever dreamt of. However, he is upset because he has never done anything without Thing 1.